Okay, in this video, we're going to go over how to do a short straddle, and we're going to look at a mechanical example here. We're going to go through the mechanics with ticker EURN, and this is Euronav. This is actually, it's a Netherlands-based crude oil tanker company. And so this is one of these trades that's a little bit on the intermediate to advanced side because it combines a covered call and a short put option. At the same time. And so it enables you to earn extra premium income kind of for similar level of risk as just the put option side of the trade. So there's some nuances about it, but there's some trade-offs. Just like everything else, there's no free lunch with options. Not too often are there free lunches. So we're going to go through an example, and by showing the examples, we'll see some different principles about the short straddle. So okay, we've got a stock here trading at 824, and as always, this is not a recommendation to buy or sell the stock. It's just this example, this stock kind of lends itself to showing certain principles of the short straddle. And so, for example, we might look at, say, selling the, and we're going to go to, first we'll just look at the January month, January 2022, and we would look at potentially selling the put option that is struck at $7 in January, and then also selling the 10 call, the strike price of 10. So we get $25, 25 cents per contract, or $25 for the 7 put option that we sell, and we have to have $700 in the account to protect it with cash. And then we're gonna be selling the 10 call and get $25 likewise for that, and we have to have it 100 shares of the stock to deliver in case the stock gets called away, okay? So for these two trades, we're going to get paid a combined premium of $50, 50 cents per contract times 100 shares. And basically, you're making a bet that the stock roughly will sit between 7 and 10. And of course, we don't know what a stock is going to do in the future, but this is the bet, essentially. If it goes below 7, you're on the hook to buy 100 shares. If it goes above 10, you're on the hook to sell 100 shares. But in return, you get paid two premiums, and they will decay over time in parallel. So I like to call this double rot. Basically, when you're selling options, you're making money from the decaying or the rotting away of time premium of that option as it approaches expiration. So here you get a double decay. You get double rot of these two option premiums at the same time, and that's what's intriguing to a lot of people about doing the short straddle. Okay, likewise, you can pick tighter strikes. So let's take a look. If we look at January, we can look at the 8 and the 9 straddle. So we would sell the 8 put option, and of course you can see you get a meaningful amount more money, right? The 7 put option paid you 25 cents, the 8 option pays you 65 cents. And then we look at the 9 call, and it pays you 40 cents versus the 10 call paying you 25 cents. So instead of a combined premium of $50, we're getting a combined premium of $105, more than twice as much, by picking strike prices that are a lot tighter around the current stock price of $8.24. So the thing is, though, you know, basically this trade, it's a neutral trade. It doesn't mean, you know, when you make this trade, you're hoping that the stock sits between these two strikes. And this is a tanker company. I can almost guarantee it won't sit between the 8 and 9 strike. Actually, for that matter, it probably won't sit between the 7 and 10 strike. These stocks are destined to surprise us positively or negatively. So in a lot of ways, this options transaction doesn't really pay you that much given kind of the outcomes and the likelihood of scenarios of it staying between these strike prices. But you want to look at different types of companies. Some companies might be paying attractive premiums, but the stock doesn't move around that much. Or one of the strategies I like to do is to have a core position in a stock and then play with a straddle for, say, 10 or 20% of additional shares. So, for example, one thing I could do, you could buy, say, 1,000 shares of Euronav, so you'd have an $8,000 position of, underlying core position, and then you might do, say, one or two straddles just as a bonus. So if you did, you know, a straddle and stock got called away, okay, you have to sell 100 or 200 shares depending on how many contracts you do. So your 1,000 share position becomes 900 or 800 shares. So a lot of times what I'll do is have a larger core position, but play around at the edges with one or two contracts representing 10 or 20% of the position. And then you get some premium income. You know, the company pays a dividend as well, so you get some dividend income. And it's not life or death whether the stock gets put to you or gets called away. It doesn't really matter. So a lot of times I'll do this when I have a stock that I want to hold, but I don't really care whether I own 100 or 200 shares more or 100 or 200 shares less, and I'll just do this for the premium income. And then we can look at one other example here. We'll look at the February month, and we can see you get paid just a little bit more. So if we look at the 8 put option, remember the 8 in January paid you 65 cents. Well, the February 8 put option pays you 75 cents, so a little bit more. And then likewise, we got 40 cents for the January 9 call option. Well, here you get 45 cents. So if you were to go out one more month and do the tight straddle, you'd actually get $1.20 instead of $1.05. So a little bit more money for that extra month. And this is a sort of a good illustration of the time money relationship, the time value relationship of options. The more time to expiration, all else equal, the more value that the option has. And when you're selling these options, you're getting that premium and then hoping it decays away over time. All right. So that's the short straddle. As always, I hope these videos are helpful, and we'll be doing some more option strategies going forward. Thanks so much for watching.